She got it broken 2 years ago and has screws and plates in it. Donovan back to the point. Corbo delays, snaps it through for a tip. Scores! Puck is knocked out of midair by Chris Kelly. And the shutout bid is busted. And one referee says it's good. Other says it's waved off. Now they're both going to go back and check the video. Is the stick too high?
This puck is going to be bouncing in the air, and Chris Kelly is going to backhand whack it. And great hand-eye coordination. It's going to come to the net, and it's going to go up into the air as it comes right there. And he just turns around and whacks it. Now, it's not that the stick is over his shoulder, the toe of the stick. It's where the puck hits, if it goes off the heel of the stick, and is it below the crossbar. The referee that's out in the neutral zone will get a good look at it, and it looks to be slightly above the crossbar, and he would have the right vantage point to see it. The referee behind the net might not get a good look at it as he turns and hits that. And it's so hard because he's not close to the net. He's out far. So the perception of it is it's really hard to tell whether his stick, when it makes contact with the puck, is above the crossbar or not.
Let me ask you this question. The way it works is, if this video is deemed to be inconclusive, then it goes to the call on the ice. The original call by the referee on the goal line was goal. The original call from the referee at center ice near the blue line was no goal. Who wins? Which is the call?
I believe the referee behind the net is signaling the puck went into the net. Then he looks to his other referee who says it was a high stick, and then he waved it off as well. They both did wave the goal off. Once it was identified, it was a high stick. But the goal behind the net, he's just calling it that the puck has crossed the line. Right. Because right here he turns, and because he's so far out, I know it's going to be very difficult to tell. It's so difficult because I don't think he gets the puck on the toe of his stick. I think he gets it more towards the heel, towards the bottom. As he turns here, the fat part of the heel is where he gets it. And I think this is going to come back because just the fact the player in front ducked.
Yeah.
And the puck is traveling over his head. And the referees on the ice did both wave it. I think it's going to have to be either pretty obvious that this thing was not above. And from this vantage point, to me, it almost looks like it is. But again, the perception, because it's so high out into the slot area, as you see the puck go off the ruined stick, and then as he turns around, it looks to be just a tad over the crossbar.
They have now waved it off. And I'm not sure, you know, from that distance, because they can't tell exactly. It looks like it was over, but they can't tell exactly. That's when you get into that. The original call on the ice stands because the video may have been inconclusive, even though it appears pretty clear to us it was over. But even if it's inconclusive and it goes to the call on the ice, which was no goal.
It almost has to come from the side, you know what I mean, Dean? It's got to come from the side of the angle so that you can almost see the net and his stick from the side. Coming from behind and coming from the top won't help you with that one.